Hey everyone, I wanted to do a little prospector video here. Silver Bar Stacker just did one on some of the variations on the 1985, and I've noticed some stuff with them that some of it I haven't heard anybody really talking about, and I've kind of ran it through my head, and it's pretty much opinion. Well, it is my opinion, but it kind of does back up what Silver Bar Stacker was saying. And I just kind of wanted to jump in here and give my 2 cents worth. So, let me start with the 85. Because this is the one we were talking about in the video. And see, next to the pan there, just off to the side of the pan on the left. See those ripples in the water? There's like five right there. You can see them pretty good. There's like five or six ripples in the water there. 1985. There's also 1985 without the ripples. And in 1985 without the ripples, with this really screwy, the date is bigger. So let's start with the first year, 1982, big E, but notice the E is somewhat smooth. All the other years, it's got way more texture going on. So that's something I've noticed with the 82s. And notice the ripples right off the edge of the pan. There's just a couple little specks. Then we go on to the 83. It's pretty much the same, just a couple little specks. '84, same thing. They got the more textured E. And then in '84, also very clean there by the pan, they went to the Eagle, which is probably my favorite Eagle on anything. Just as cool. So then we get to 85. So before we get there, so we're in 1984. They're just pumping out these rounds saying, oh, aren't these neat? 85 comes around, it's time to retool to turn it into 1985 because it's no longer 1984. So what I'm wondering is the date is raised. So in the die, that date is set into it. I'm wondering if there's a possibility that they filled that date, recut the 1985 over the 84, made a few of them. Somebody says that looks like crap with that great big 1985 on there. And they stopped production at that point, which would explain the low number of the big date. Then they take that die that they just redid, maybe they redo it again to correct the date, and they start running those out for a while, thinking to themselves, geez, I hope these new dies come in because we're having all these die issues. Then at some point, they get a nice die in there with the correct date, with the new ripples, compared to no ripples, the correct date, or the one, I believe the first one is the one with the big ugly date. They corrected the date and said, oh, these die issues. They ordered a new one with ripples. Because why not? They just got done buying a new reverse die. Kind of makes sense. Then you get to 86. And you still got those big ripples. And they continue on all the way through 87. So I think the orders are maybe a little bit weird. I'm thinking 1985, the first ones are the great big date after redoing an 84 die, turning it into an 85. Somebody said, no, ugly, that's bad. They recut the date more correctly, but by then they already had a die over to replace the dies. And that would explain why in 1985 there's a change. So it's not the 85 has this style with the big, with the details in the water. It's not that the 85 has that variation. It seems to continue from that point through the rest of the series. So anyway, that was kind of my two cents on there. I'm seeing a couple ways it can go about, but it seems to me that that would make be the way that would make the most sense. It's not like you're going to be making them with a good date and then all of a sudden make it ugly. But going the other way around, can going from one year to the other, I could see where that mistake would happen. So anyway, that was something I just wanted to throw together. Well, you know, one more thing at some point. See, that one's got stuff in the pan. 83, you have more stuff in the pan. 84, you got the stuff in the pan, both 84s. 85, there's less in that pan too. So anyway, thanks everybody for listening to me mumble and watching, and we'll see you in the next one.